Okay, I'm joined here by Emmett Smith, People Before Profit. The count, the first count, should be happening in the next hour or so. But from the tallies, Emmett, how do you feel that you got on?
So I suppose it's a threefold jump from the last time. So three times more people have voted for me than the last general election. I want to say massive thanks to all those people. It's brilliant. And not only for one, it's a series of threes. It's been a good vote. I think we can't go without talking about the Sinn Féin surge. It's been absolutely massive and it's squeezed McCarney to 11. But given that, it's still a good vote.
But that's what we're discussing, is that it does appear to be a very good vote, our election for Sinn Féin. Who would be perceived, I don't know, would you regard Sinn Féin as left-wing? Some left-wing purists might regard them as maybe chameleons. You know, they're not actually genuine lefties. So, but how come you're, like, if there is a desire, a thirst for left-wing politics, how come People Before Profit seem to have difficulty tapping in?
I don't think we have difficulty tapping in. I think, you know, we're still doing very well. We're holding most of our seats. We're holding strong where we have a presence. I suppose in more conservative regions like this, Sinn Féin has been, you know, seen as they have established the vote for a long time. And even to get to that position, it took them a lot of trying. Like, it hasn't, didn't happen overnight either.
No.
So I think taking it in that context, Sinn Féin are perceived as a left-wing party. That is the way that they're facing. Their policies, their manifesto is definitely leading. Whether or not now is the major test of it. And I don't think, I wouldn't even say it's a purist position. But the major test would be to see will they go into coalition with the right.
And what do you think that they could temper the right by going into coalition, or would you be completely
personally
opposed to them?
No, I wouldn't think that they could temper the right. I have no faith in anybody's, any party's ability to temper the right. I think we've seen the Green Party, the bank bailout, we've seen with Labour and enforcing austerity, that a left wing party going in with Fianna Fáil, Fianna Fáil again, and abandon all principles because they just can't be against by that law.
Okay. So, looking at your own personal vote, I think you got 200 generally first preference, we're talking in Monaghan, and further 500 odd in Cavan, so a total of 700 or something. For that to translate into a local authority level, you're talking about doubling that to try to get elected in Cavan County Council. Would you go again?
I would go again, of course, yeah. I suppose we've gone from 250 in the first general election as part of the Right to Change policy platform, and I think if we had had more of a something like that again, we would have more candidates back in around over 100 candidates. If we had have had that now, we could have translated into a solid left government. It just didn't happen. But we went from 250 to almost 500 in the locals last time, which was, you know, not too far away from actually achieving a seat there in Cavan. And then to, you know, again, raise the vote again, you know, in the midst of a lot of pressure from Sinn Féin. Surges are gone. So, you know, I think we are continuing to grow. The support is massive. Like, we're looking at the votes, the twos, the threes, the fours. Like, you know, there is an appetite there for
people. So you're confident that you're going to get a fair few transfers?
The seat is not without, it's not beyond the possibility of seeing the calendar in the future.
Okay, perfect. Thank you very much.